Hello everyone. In this video, we will demonstrate what is Rubens tube and how it works. Rubens was a German physicist who born in Nassau, Germany in 1865 and died in Berlin in 1922. He studied electric engineering and then he went to Berlin University to further research about physics. There he benefited much more from many lecturers and physicists like August Kundt, Ferdinand, Max Planck, and many other researchers and conferences that were held. Rubens was well known for many of his famous researches. One of them is blackbody radiation, which led Max Planck to the discovery of his radiation law, which also helps in discovering more about quantum physics. In the meanwhile, in 1905, he constructed Rubens tube to illustrate the relationship between sound waves and sound pressure. A Rubens tube, also known as a standing wave flame tube or simply flame tube. It is an antique physics apparatus for demonstrating acoustic standing waves in a tube. The original Rubens tube was a 4-meter section pipe with approximately 100 holes of 2 mm diameter spaced evenly along its length. The pipe was then sealed at both ends. One seal is attached to a small speaker or a frequency generator and the other to a supply of flammable gas. The pipe is filled with gas and the gas leaking from the holes is lit. It will form a row of flames of roughly equal sizes. If a suitable constant frequency is used, a standing wave can form within the tube. When the speaker is turned on, the standing wave will create points with oscillating pressure and points with constant pressure along the tube. Where there is oscillating pressure due to the sound waves, less gas will escape from the holes and thus the flames will be lower at those points. And at the pressure nodes, the flames will be higher. So in this video, we will make an experimental piece with some scrap materials and demonstrate how it works. For this, we will use a few basic tools, an empty DO can that will be used as a metal pipe, a balloon for making our diaphragm, a lighter or a DO can will be used as a gas tank, some pipes and joints to connect, some tape, glue and some small stuffs, and some plywood for making our base. So let's build it now. Here we will use an empty DO can as our metal pipe. So let's disassemble it now first and remove unnecessary parts. Then we will mark 14 holes through the length, each are separated 1/4 inch apart. You need to push the marks first by the drawing compass and then we will use a pin to make holes in it. For the diaphragm, we will use a normal balloon. Just cut it and tightly bind it to the end. It It's really hard to do alone, but somehow I manage. So for the pipes to connect, I used 6mm aquarium pipes and some pipe joints and a regulator for controlling our gas pressure. Let's connect all this now. We will use a lighter as a gas tank as of now, so open it and separate unnecessary parts. We will use a small nut and bolt to hold our lever so that a continuous gas flow may occur. I will connect a 2mm pipe to the nozzle and it will lead to the regulator. So let's experiment now. First thing I saw that my flames are real too low and not lighting fully. What I noticed that my gas was leaking from the nozzle of the lighter. Hence I fixed it and tried it again. Now also the flames are very low as you can see and it is not as expected. So I removed my lighter and replaced it with a filled DO can. I made a hole in the top and connected it through a pipe. Now you can see the flames are much higher than before. Also, I can now control the flow with the help of my regulator. If I tap my finger in the diaphragm, it will also create a pressure inside the tube and thus the waves will affect the flames too. Instead of this, if we place a speaker or a frequency generator near the diaphragm and turn it on, the standing wave will create higher and lower pressure points and constant pressure points along the holes. Where there is higher and lower pressure points due to the sound waves, the flames will be lower, and at constant pressure points, the flames will be higher. Hence, our tube also runs smoothly and works fine. So thank you everyone. If you learned something from our experiment, don't forget to leave a like. Also, share with your friends who are interested in such an experiment, and subscribe to the channel if you are new. And also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos.